Well, the stupidity is skyrocketing this week.
I'm the librarian.
And I came to read. I hope you guys remember that on Tuesday, just like every Tuesday this fucking year and the years to come, we're going to be releasing a new episode of For the Culture Podcast on ForTheCulturePodcast.com. So make sure that you are checking that shit out. Make sure that you're over here listening, getting your life on your lunch break, before you go to work, wherever. For the Culture Podcast is always here for you. Remember also Patreon.com/AdrianExpression, where you can get the best content first. The videos that were released today were released first on Patreon.com/AdrianExpression. So go there and sign up. Here we are talking about Miss BET. Nobody told me that they did shit like this. Now look at their Instagram. Look at some posts that they put on motherfucking Instagram, bitch. And I'm just like, girl, you always want to pass out fucking black cards. We first need to pass out a black card to the owner of BET company, sis. That's the first thing we need to do. But you hoes talking about giving honorary black cards to people who have one black card to give a politician, who would you give it to? Like our blackness. I mean, and I guess it's kind of ironic since this is a business and they're acting like our blackness is just something to be sold and to be offered up like it's a fucking, you know, ancient ass sacrifice. I hate it so much. All the real work that BET could be doing in the community, you know, the career changing promotion that it could give to up and coming artists, the fact that it could spend all of its resources highlighting activists or highlighting certain events that are happening in the community. Like, girl, it could be a tool for such construction in our community. Instead, they're using it for destruction. I'm not sure what's going on, but I'm not gonna spend too much time on that shit. What I want to spend a lot of time on is T.I. ass, but I can't do that shit because he didn't even spend enough time on building common decency to operate like a normal human being in this goddamn society. T.I. is over here acting like gay, I mean agreeing with Nipsey Hussle, okay, acting like gays are the just worst, you know, the Armageddon of the black community. You're acting like, you know, just because I want to play around with some testicles, it's going to destroy whatever we've built, you know, just because my ass likes to walk around here in cheap ass crop tops or some shit, that my femininity, even though, you know, those were rules created by humans, my femininity will destroy the black community. Now, sis, T.I. did a quick Google search. It really did not take me motherfucking long. And these are just five of your arrest records. Now, you're talking about gay people who like their prostate rubbed. They're going to be over here destroying the black community when, you know, we're looking at arrests and convictions from your ass. Let's name some of them. Manufacturing and distributing crack cocaine. Okay, battery of a law enforcement officer. Now, this particular incident was interesting because his ass was acting rowdy. Him and his entourage were acting rowdy as hell at some mall. And the police officer was just like, hey, sis, we just like for y'all to leave, y'all acting too much. And instead of fucking leaving, T.I. allegedly just assaulted a female fucking officer. We're moving the fuck along. Probation violation. We're moving along. Purchase and possession of automatic weapons. We're moving the fuck along. Possession of controlled substances. So when I'm sitting, you see why I can't take you seriously? You see why I can't take you seriously? You think of my necklaces and fucking half-ass tops are gonna be over here destroying the community when you're over here literally assaulting, committing crimes, having fucking possession of weapons, selling fucking drugs. Who is really, me sucking dick is gonna fucking fuck the black community up, or you over here distributing drugs and fucking firearms and assaulting people, girl? We have to examine why, you know, as males, and it's just not in the black community, it's just men in general, why is it cooler for them to be shooting shit up versus fucking kissing another man, bitch? Why is it cooler for them to be punching people in the face versus have their arm around their motherfucking best friend who happens to be male, bitch? You got to figure that out, because one leads to fucking death and destruction, and one is literally fucking love. Girl, get out my face. Now, if you've had your eyes open this week, you will know that H&M in South Africa has received a series of vandalizations, girl. They went in there and turned shit up and out. Now, my immediate reaction when I went onto Twitter was to say, girl, this shit sounds really stupid to me. This shit sounds dumb. And for the most part, a lot of those types of protests seem really dumb to me. Because my thought was, I was like, girl, the people who you're trying to exalt and make sure that are being respected are the ones who are gonna have to clean up this mess. I was like, girl, companies, they take out insurance on shit so they can just have the shit back up and running without any problem. They like to write shit off on their taxes. So I was just like, girl, that when I saw the H&M shit, I was just like, girl, this shit looks really stupid to me. Putting minorities, honestly, in the hot seat when it comes to who has to clean the shit up and the hourly workers and shit. But then today, South Africa just closed all their stores, and I'm just like, girl, obviously you made H&M stop and think about something. And that's the whole purpose of protesting. So I'm just like, how do you guys deal with that? Like, on one hand, it's like, obviously, girl, all the H&M stores in South Africa are closed. Obviously, it's gonna make them re-examine something. They would not have done that. They would not have closed all their stores if they did not think that the rest of them were at risk, girl, or they got something wrong. So I'm wondering how you guys think about that shit. Because on one hand, there will be a lot of people missing fucking income if we have stores shut down. But on the other hand, it was effective. So I'd like to hear in the comments what you guys think about that. Now, imagine waking up one morning, you know, sipping your coffee, whatever it is that you do, you know, making your way around the kitchen for maybe some toast, and you see this pop up on your goddamn phone. Read it. Read it. Yes, ma'am. They said this is not a fucking drill. Apparently, this happened in Hawaii, and it happened on accident. Now, the people got this message and were very shook for about 38 fucking minutes. Now, let me tell you something. If I got that shit, if that shit happened right now on my motherfucking phone, and that hoe said this is not a drill, ballistic missiles coming in on my ass, I don't even think, I was literally thinking, like, how would I even process? Would I be in shock? Would I pass out? Because it's like, bitch, There's really nothing that you can do, because I don't know of any bunkers. Maybe I would get in my car and see if I could drive to it. I would be shaking. I think we don't even know how we react in these situations, because it's just so much fight or flight that you can't predict the shit, okay? So I think Jim Carrey was in Hawaii when this happened. Please forgive me if I'm wrong, but he was just like, yeah, girl, this shit is life-changing. And, you know, Hawaii said, girl, we fucked it up. I'm so sorry. Like, this did not mean to happen. It was just supposed to be a test, but that shit, it went terribly wrong and had people panicking. So I don't know, like, who the fuck would I call? What the fuck would the TV? I think it would just be a state of panic. It would be worldwide. It would be nationwide news. So I would get, my phone would be blowing the fuck up. It's just, I think it would be too much to handle. I think I would be overstimulated, just like I feel like I am talking about it right now. But Jim Carrey went on and said, yeah, girl, we need to go ahead and just get this bitch out of the motherfucker office. He didn't say it like that, but he was just like, girl, this is a possibility with this man as president. If we let him continue to destroy the global community, girl, like, it's a possibility, and it's not worth it. So we need to get his ass out of office. And as I said earlier, I don't understand why people claim to love this country so much, and yet they had this man over here in the Oval Office shitting all over the fucking presidential seal. I don't understand it. I don't understand that shit. And what I don't understand is how Donald Trump thinks he's going to recover from calling other countries shithole countries. I talked about that earlier, but there has been a lot of news about Donald Trump leaking out this week. And to really substantiate the fact that we all know his ass is fucking racist, Trump was told that not everybody on welfare is black. And he was like, girl, really? Then what are they? And I'm just like, Donald Trump, with your, you know, dying dolphin-shaped head ass, you should know that a majority of the people who are on welfare are your fucking base. And the idiots voted for your ass thinking that you would be this life-changing ass savior, and instead you just bring them more poverty, less publicly funded programs. You're literally fucking them over, and they're gassing you up, they're patting you on the back as you do it. There was a lot of other interesting news here. A former porn star reached a 130,000, Jesus. Just give that shit to me, girl. Girl, you might want to ask him for the money back, because a former porn star reached a $130,000 deal just before the 2016 election to stay silent about an alleged sexual encounter with Donald Trump. Obviously, as I said, those $130,000 don't mean much now, because we know about that shit now. Moving the fuck along, Stormy Daniels isn't the only porn star Trump was in contact with in 2006. He was also, you know, messing around with Jessica Drake. He offered her $10,000 in the use of his private jet if she agreed to sleep with him. He did some of this shit while he was with Melania, and of course that comes as no surprise to people with working brains. I mean, we've been new. I don't know, maybe Trump is so used to paying people and getting what he wants that he thinks that the presidency works like that. It's just like, girl, you're in for a rude ass awakening, okay? And a lot of people would be in for a rude ass awakening if they, you know, happen to wake up next to your ass, bitch. That's a very, very rude awakening. So I really, maybe somebody, if those of you who are religious, because I am not, those of you who are religious, maybe if you want to send up a prayer for these porn stars, because they have been emotionally scarred, imagine waking up next to fucking Donald Trump. Girl, kiss my ass. Now, a lot of people have been saying, girl, Donald Trump's wig is shifting. His wig is shifting. There's something wrong. There's something going on with him. And, you know, the White House is saying, says, we don't understand why y'all are pressed. We don't understand why y'all are pressed. He's fine. We did a physical on his ass. We're looking at his ass. And he's looking good. He's looking okay. You know, never mind the fact that his skin is serving me rotting ass cottage cheese. You know, he's okay. A particular country who does not believe that Donald Trump is okay is Botswana. Okay, and they heard what the tea was, that they heard Donald Trump's comments, and they said, sis, what's up? They said the headline was just like, Botswana asks the U.S. to clarify if it is one of the shithole countries. So Botswana, you heard those comments, said, bitch, what's up? You said shithole countries, bitch, where? I looked in the mirror and you said a shithole country. I said, bitch, where? Where is it? Where? I want to know. And Botswana was just like, girl, you know, we've had a good relationship with the United States for so long, we don't understand why these comments came out in the motherfucking first place. We want to know. And there was an African group, and I'll show a picture. They demanded an apology. This is a sickening ass letter. They said, girl, we demand a retraction and apology. We are extremely appalled at and strongly condemn the outrageous, racist, and xenophobic remarks attributed to the President of the United States as widely reported by the media. Now, I'm glad they're giving us the benefit of the doubt, because they said, we thank the American people from all walks of life and backgrounds who have condemned the remarks. So I'm hoping maybe the spirit of a lot of these American people, some of the American people, will convince other countries not to completely turn their backs against us. You know, they can turn their backs against Trump, but not us. You know what I mean? I don't know if that can work. I don't know if that type of separation exists within the minds of these global politicians, but I hope so, because I don't want to wake up like Jim Carrey did. I don't want to wake up with no fucking message talking about, hey sis, it's your motherfucking last moment, so girl, I don't know what you need to do. You need to call some people and say goodbye, sis, because you're about to be control off deleted out this motherfucking program. The easiest thing to do is sit your ass down and do nothing. But if we allow this man to, he will destroy democracy, okay? Doing nothing and thinking shit will just go away, girl, no man. I mean, that's how you end up with a snowball effect, a rabbit hole, girl. You wake up one day in a country you don't fucking recognize. So what we need to do is get our asses out there in November, girl. Flip this shit. Flip this shit. Get your asses up. Get active, girl. In November, we need to flip this shit. We need to make sure that we are constantly keeping ourselves aware of the issues, so nothing, if we can help it, catches us by surprise. Don't do nothing. At the very least, stay aware. Knowledge is power, sis. Ignorance is how we got here. Have a good goddamn evening.